Hi guys, welcome to the first episode of This Moment in Design, the show where we talk about interesting design books, movies, and courses. Today I'm going to review Make It So, Interaction Design Lessons from Science Fiction. Make It So, which is also what I say to the shopkeeper when my bill is 95 rupees and I put in some chewing gum and I say, Bhaiya, make it so. So the book is authored by Nathan Shredoff and Christopher Noessel. You might know Christopher Noessel as one of the co-authors of the book About Face, which is a great interaction design textbook that I recommend you read when you have the free time. This book is a study of the user interfaces found in science fiction films and TV shows. There are various types of interfaces examined in this book, and there are examples from lots of different movies. Most of the movies and shows that I expected to see in this book are there, and there are also some gems that I discovered from this book. This book takes the lessons part of its title very seriously, and there are things to teach from each example. For instance, there is a chapter on visual design, and some of the lessons from that chapter are: sci-fi interfaces are mostly blue, sci-fi interfaces use mostly sans serif fonts, sci-fi interfaces use all caps, don't use all caps. And in a nutshell, these are the kind of lessons and depth you should expect from this book. There are no aha moments, there are no eye-openers, and there are no insights in this book. For any reasonably skilled practitioner, most of the lessons will be quite obvious. The lessons themselves are a mix of industrial design and interaction design. For example, use non-rectangular shaped screens to make them look more advanced is probably advice that is more relevant for an industrial designer. This book is quite comprehensive. It covers buttons, gestures, telepresence, AR, VR, all kinds of areas. But the writing style of this book just leaves a lot to be desired. The chapters are mostly disconnected from one another, and there is no general theme or approach that a designer could learn from this book. Just individual, bite-sized lessons. Ultimately, watching science fiction is a lot more fun than reading about it in this book. The book medium itself is not suitable for the kind of interactivity that this book talks about. If this were a documentary, I think I would like it. I do recommend checking out sci-fi-interfaces.com, the companion website for this book, where there are videos for some of the examples. I imagine that this is the kind of book that sits well at a coffee table and starts interesting conversations. So if you're going to get it, get the paperback version. That'll also be easier to read since the book has a lot of pictures. Now, here are the three best things that I learned from this book. Number one, eye contact during video calls. This is a lesson learned from observing holographic communication in movies like Star Wars. People don't make eye contact during video calls. They either look at themselves or they look into the lens. What the system could do is it could adjust the eye positions of both the callers in the video feed to make it appear as if they are talking eye to eye. This will make the conversation a little more natural and human-like. Apple is in fact already at work on something like this. Number two, a great demo can hide many flaws. Demoing the key features of an interface can allow you to sell it well without revealing all the problems with it. The motion control interface in Minority Report looks amazing, but would be exhausting to use in real life. Rumor has it that during shooting, Tom Cruise had to continuously take breaks to keep his arms from aching. Number three, keep the robotic voice. If a voice interface sounds too natural, people will consider it to be human or have human-like capabilities. In the 1980s, the Atlanta airport train used a pre-recorded human voice to give instructions and announce stops. Riders would take more chances and rush the doors because they thought that a human conductor was watching them and would wait for them. This human voice was soon replaced with a computerized, robotic-sounding voice to avoid such accidents. The lesson is, make your interface sound human-like only if it has the intelligence to meet the expectations that come with that. This book is basically an extensive survey and is not meant to replace interaction design curriculum. It offers an alternative take on interaction design learning and reinforces lessons in design principles for color, typography, usability, etc. It also offers some tips for how to design for emerging technologies such as AR, VR, telepresence, holograms, and so on. Nearly all of the advice is genuine and the lessons are unquestionable, but they're also mostly very obvious. Probably the worst part about this book is that it has spoilers for the movies that it talks about. This book completely spoiled Moon for me, which was one of my retirement movies. It also has spoilers for 2001 A Space Odyssey, Serenity, and The Day the Earth Stood Still. So if you're going to watch any of these movies, just skip those sections. I'm going to give this relatively thick book 2.5 stars out of 5. Now, I love speculative design and design fictions, but I could hardly recommend this as a reference book for those areas. Hey guys, if you liked the video, like the video. Do remember to leave your comments and subscribe and follow.